Today we are going to learn about informal letters. Informal letters are those which are written to friends and relatives to know about them, to share information, to share your achievements, or to tell them some good news, or maybe at times yes, bad as well. So informal letters do not have any kind of formality in them, but still they do have a format. In exams you need to write in a format properly if you're given an informal letter. So let's learn about the format. Now we learn the correct method of writing an informal letter. We start with a sender's address from the top left hand corner. Mind it, top left hand corner we write the sender's address. Suppose your address is house number 504. So you can write either house number 504. Suppose it is Nandini Road, and the name of the city with, suppose the pin code is also there, and you must write the pin code. So this is how you write the address. You write your house number, then the street, maybe the area, and then the city, and then the pin code. So this is how you write the sender's address from the top left hand corner always. Then comes the date. Date is also very important to write because everybody must know when you have written the letter. But there is a format of writing the date. Suppose that is 18th September. So you write 18th September 2018. This is how you write date without leaving any line between the sender's address and the date. Sender's address means the one who is sending the letter to you. The one who is sending the letter. So I mean the writer of the letter. Writer of the letter is the sender. So before the after the sender's address, you have to write the date in this format. Then comes the salutation. Salutation means if you're writing to your mom, you'll write respected mom, dear mom. If you're writing to a suppose an old friend of yours, so you'll definitely write dear, dearest, my dear. So that's called salutation. Dear or my dear or maybe respected. That depends on your relationship with that person to whom you're writing the letter. Then comes three paragraphs. This is the most important part of an informal letter. The three parts are there. The very first paragraph will contain why you are writing the letter. That means in the first paragraph you have to mention why you have written this letter. Suppose you have to give some good news to your mom that you are coming back from hostel after a week. So that's a very good news for your mom. So in the very first paragraph you have to mention that this letter is supposed to tell you that I'm coming on coming next week to meet you from the hostel. So this will tell you, this paragraph will give all the details of why you are writing the letter. Then the second paragraph comes where you elaborate all these details. Elaborate the details. This is also very important. As you see, like in the first paragraph, suppose Amit is coming from hostel and he has told his mom that if there is a good news, I'm coming back from hostel. Next paragraph will tell all the details, like the flight details, maybe how many days he is going to stay with his mom, or some other achievement also that he had in his hostel in the school. So he'll be telling all those details in this elaborate the details. That means the second paragraph. And then comes the third paragraph, which is again a repetition of the first. Repetition of the subject. Maybe again you repeat that I am coming back and I hope you will be ready with your best sweets which I like from childhood. So in case of that, you have to repeat the subject whichever because of which the letter has been written. So you repeat that subject once again and then you take leave taking. Leave taking is that you are saying bye for now. So that means yours affectionately, sincerely yours, yours obediently, faithfully yours, yours faithfully. So these kind of like yours faithfully, sincerely yours. These are very good leave-taking notes, sincerely yours. Because you are saying bye to a person whom you have written a letter. Then comes the signing off. Minded signing off means writing your name. You cannot write your surname here as this is an informal letter. So you have to be very careful while writing your name. It's just yours faithfully or sincerely yours. This, not both of them can be used. Yours faithfully or sincerely yours. Or maybe if you have asked for a favor, you can write thanking you, yours faithfully. Thanking you will come just above this, then yours faithfully followed by your name. So this is the format of writing an informal letter. Again, I'll repeat, the sender's address is the house number, then the street, then the city, and then the pin code. Without leaving any line, you write the date in this format, and then you write the salutation. See, it is either dear or my dear or dearest or respected. So this is the salutation part. Again, we are not leaving any line here. Then comes the main body of the letter, that is three paragraphs, that is the body of the letter. The first paragraph will tell why the letter has been written. Second will elaborate all the details of the letter, and the third will be a repetition or maybe thanks or maybe an expectation that we'll be dealing later on. And the last, leave taking and signing off, and that means yours faithfully or thanking you sincerely yours, followed by your name without the surname. So this is the format of an informal letter. So here we'll learn how to write this letter. Suppose you have been given, you are a student of Yale School, Dehradun. You have been selected as the house captain and you wish to share the information with your mom. Write a letter to your mom, giving her the good news. So see, this letter can be from you, which you are staying in a hostel. So you have to give your hostel number and the hostel room and then the name of the school with the city pin code. So you have been selected as the house captain. This is the news that you want to get. This has to come in the very first paragraph of the letter. And then you can give a good news also that you are coming for vacations for a week or so, because that can be a very good news to your mom as you are staying in a hostel. So let's see how to write this letter. So here we start writing this letter. First, as I said, the sender's address will be there on the top left hand corner of the page. Top left hand corner is this one, and here you have to write the hostel number, the room number, the name of the school, the city and the pin code. In short, you can write the last two digits can be written. So this is what I said as the sender's address. This has to be on the top left hand corner of the letter, and there is no space between the address and the margin. Then, without leaving any line, write the date in this format. Suppose it is 19th September, then 19th September, comma, the year 2018. Then comes the salutation part, again without leaving any line, and there is no gap between the margin and the salutation. So this is dear mom, it can be respected mom. And then starts the main body of the letter, that is the very first paragraph in which you are going to give her the good news. Now we start writing the very first paragraph of the letter. It begins with, wish this letter of mine finds you in good health. Because you are always going to ask your mom, how is she, how are you doing, what about it? You know, if you have a small brother, what about him? So this is what the starting line should be. Wish this letter of mine finds you in good health. Then, you would be delighted to hear that I have been finalized for the position of the house captain of Himadri House of our school. So here you have given the news, that means the subject of the letter is there in the very first paragraph, because you are giving her a news that you have been selected as the house captain, and this has to be there in the very first paragraph of the letter. See this, there is no space between the margin and the beginning of the paragraph. So in this manner you have to write the within the margin. Now comes the second paragraph of the letter where I have to elaborate all the details which happened there, like exactly what happened in the interview round, what happened in the final round. So that details I have to include in the second paragraph. You don't have to write paragraph 2 here. It's just because I'm writing on the other page and I'm giving you the paragraph number. Just leave a line after the first paragraph and then start writing from the margin. This is how you write the second paragraph, that is the main body. The selection process was a lengthy one, which started around 2 weeks ago. After the physical test, we wrote a mental ability test. Here only 12 participants were finalized out of 36. Then we had a group discussion where only 6 were finalized. Then began the interview round, where only three of us were finalized. The results of this were announced by our principal sir in the assembly today. I was overjoyed to hear my name being called out. All my friends and teachers congratulated me and wished me luck. So this is how you give all the details of the interview round with the group discussion round. This contains the details. As I said, elaborate the details here. This is the main body of the letter. Then comes the third paragraph, where you repeat that message and then you give some maybe better news that you're coming back home or something of that sort, which is an ending to the letter. So let's see the paragraph 3. Now comes the third paragraph of the letter, which is again a repetition of what you have already told and maybe some other good news which you are sharing with her now. So this is, I wish I could give the news to you personally. There is another good news for you. I would be coming on 5th October and would be there with you all for a week. Will send the flight details in my next letter. Convey my regards to dad and love to Bunty. See, you have to convey your regards to your dad and love to your own sibling, maybe brother, maybe younger brother, maybe elder brother. And then you take the leave taking, yours obediently, because you are writing to your mom, yours affectionately, faithfully yours, anything sincerely yours will also do. But yours obediently sounds better, and then followed by this is your name. Because name has to be there, no surname has to be there. And then you see this, everything is near the margin. We don't leave any gap in between. There's no need of a thanking you in this letter. So this is how you write an informal letter. In the next part, we'll be dealing with few more informal letters of this kind. And the one which here, suppose Aman has written that he'll be giving the flight details in the next letter. So in the next part, we'll be dealing how to give the flight details and the reply of his mom as well. Because he has written to his mom about his achievement and she'll congratulate him. So two letters we'll be dealing in few coming parts. Thank you. Hope you're liking all our videos. So send in your queries and suggestions in the comment box. Share the videos with your friends and watch out for the latest videos. Press the bell icon. Subscribe to Idea Infinity.